Welcome to the session, students. Today we are dealing on the topic that is nothing but linear differential equation, finding the solutions for linear differential equations from your unit 1. So already we were learning how to find the solutions for non-homogeneous linear differential equation, and how to find solution for homogeneous equation is already dealt in the previous classes. Okay. Now how to find the solution for this equation? That is nothing but we have to find the complementary solution and also the particular solution. Complementary solution we have already found and we have obtained that is yc is equal to c1 e power minus 2x plus c2 e power x. Now we have to find the particular solution. So to find the particular solution, I'll consider this y, that is this whole thing, is equal to 2x minus 40 cos 2x. So in our previous class we have learned about how to find the solution when the question is given, right? That is how to find when the particular solution is given, how to find the equation, we have dealt in our previous class. The same thing we are using here. That is nothing but here we will get it as yp is equal to, since it is 2x, I can write it as a plus bx. If it is x square, a plus bx plus cx square, clear? Plus, here it is cos 2x. I'm not considering the signs, I'm only considering the cos 2x here. Since it is cos 2x, I can write it as c cos 2x. Here, one d already we are using for this one. So if once again I'll use d as a constant here, we may get confused. So instead of that, I'll use e sine 2x. You can use c1, c2, c3, c4 also. Okay. For c1, c2, I have already used. So I'm using the alphabets a, b, c and e. Now, we have written the solution yp, particular solution, but we don't know the value of a, b, c and e. So to find the particular values of a, b, c and e, what we do is we differentiate this further twice and substitute in this equation star and simplify that. By simplifying that, we can obtain the values of a, b, c and e. Substitute, when we substitute the values of those in this equation yp, we'll get the particular solution. Okay, so we'll differentiate, we'll see what we will get. So clearly a is a constant, so you will get here b plus c cos x, here cos 2x, the differentiation of cos 2x is nothing but minus 2c sin 2x plus, once again here sin 2x, differentiation of that is 2e cos 2x. So you will obtain here the value as dyp. Next you have to find value for d square yp. So once again b becomes constant, avoid that. Here minus 2 once again, so you will get 4c cos 2x minus 4e sin 2x. Understood? Now what we have to do is, I'll name this equation as 1, this equation as 2. So substituting this 1 and 2 in star, we can, and simplifying it, we'll get the value of a, b, c and e. After substituting the values, we'll get minus 4 cos 2x minus 4c cos 2x minus 4e sin 2x plus b minus 2c sin 2x plus 2e cos 2x minus 2a minus 2bx next term we'll get it as minus 2 cos 2x minus 2e sin 2x is equal to 2x minus 40 cos 2x. Okay, now we have to compare the values of x and constants and also the values of cos 2x and sin 2x. Okay, when I compare the coefficients of constants, here the constant is nothing but b, then the next one is minus 2a. So I'll get here b minus 2a is equal to 0. Here both b and a are unknowns. We don't know the value of b and a. So what we do is, while we find the values of the unknowns, if there is one unknown, one equation is enough. If there is two unknowns, we need two equations. If three, then three equations we require. So what we'll do is, next we'll compare the coefficients of x. When we compare the coefficients of x, we'll get it as minus 2b. Here the coefficient of x is 2. So I'll get minus 2b is equal to minus 2. By this I can write b value is nothing but, sorry, plus 2. By this I'll get the b value as minus 1. Next, by using this one, I can find the a value. That is nothing but b value is minus 1. So minus 1 minus 2a is equal to 0. So I'll obtain minus 2a is equal to 1. So a is equal to minus half. So by this way, we obtain the value of b and a, and we'll find the values of other constants in our next class. Thank you.